the end of last season. 100 wins by anybody's account, a terrific regular season, but you don't get to where you want to go. So how do you sort of mentally all take that in?
Well, it's an abrupt end of the season. You know, especially when you have a team that you feel is capable of winning the ultimate prize. You know, we're one of those teams that certainly had a chance to do that. So when it comes crashing down and ends so suddenly, it stinks, you know. But it's also kind of why we do this. It's why you jump back into that competition and why you love kind of being in the arena and chasing that prize. And we feel like, you know, as a club, we're in a position not only short term, but continuing to be in a good position long term to have a chance to climb back up and chase it down again.
Aaron, a couple of days after that abrupt ending, you sat at Yankee Stadium, even dissected some of your own moves. Maybe you would have made a different pitching move here or there. What were the greatest lessons you learned in your first season as manager, and how will you incorporate them in year two?
Man, you know, people ask me all the time about, you know, do you look back and reflect? Every day is a reflection. You know, I mean, you know, especially doing it for the first time, you're learning. You kind of come in and take stock each and every night. Win, loss, you know, decision you made that worked out that maybe didn't. So it's a constant learning situation, and that continues in the winter as I'm, you know, I obviously live back east now, so I'm at the ballpark most days in there, you know, talking through ideas, talking through situations, talking in the office with, you know, things we're considering doing as a club as far as acquisitions and stuff. So it's a learning experience each and every day, even in the wintertime.
It's no secret Miguel Andujar had an unbelievable season. Did you ever anticipate that type of production? And what can he do to now build on that in year two?
You know, that level of production is hard to envision because for as good a club as we had, 100 wins, as good an offensive club as we had, he was really probably the one constant from beginning to end. He was really consistent. You know, we obviously dealt with some key guys being down with different injuries. Other guys struggled at times. Miggy was the one guy that night in and night out just seemed so productive. And, you know, I think going into the season, we all knew that he was capable of being an elite hitter in this league. And you wonder, at what time does that come? It came very early for him, and he was able to repeat it basically on a nightly basis. So, not shocked, but to see a young player have as great a season as he did, that's at least a pleasant surprise.